going on, guys? It's been a while, about a couple weeks. Had a little bit of a creative rut slash anxiety thing. Follow me on Instagram, you know what happened. If you haven't yet, just follow me. Just follow me, it'll be good. But we're back, and I wanna go over a few things that I've learned from a previous food photography shoot that I did just for fun. Figure you might learn something from it and maybe have some tips of your own. Give it to me, give it to the world. In the comment section below, that makes more sense. I got something really, really cool here. Let's check it out real quick. Sigma 35 f2. I've been wanting to use this lens for quite a while, and I'm really excited to go ahead and just shoot some stuff with it the next couple of weeks, let you guys in on like behind the scenes and all that stuff. So if you're into that type of stuff, feel free to subscribe to the channel and all the good stuff. And maybe follow me on Instagram, hashtag, just do it, please. Recently, shot a little butternut squash situation, a little butternut squash soup. First of all, I don't even like butternut squash. No offense to those that like it. Lately, I've been on Instagram looking at food photography pictures and on Pinterest. There's one particular person by the name of Monique. I'm gonna leave her Instagram handle down below. She's amazing at what she does when it comes to food photography. I was looking at her photos, trying to see maybe there's some things that I can actually try on my own to get better at. So I decided to go ahead and get some butternut squash, get the ingredients. And that's the first thing I wanna talk to you about, guys, about is making sure that you get everything prepped. And I mentioned this in a previous video before. I'll leave that video down below as well. You guys can check it out. Prepping is so important, especially for like food. Make sure you have the right ingredients for the dish and also the props that you wanna use already at hand so that you can go ahead and just start creating and not worry about like, oh, I gotta go to the store to get something or go upstairs or go, I don't know where your kitchen's at, but you know what I mean. So that's definitely tip number one, is making sure that you have your props and your food ready to roll and ready to get started. Now, when it comes to backdrops, there's nothing wrong with a white backdrop. As long to me personally, as long as it complements the food and the props that you have for the setting, that's awesome. Good, you're good to go. You had that set up, but I would encourage you to try maybe take it to the next level. Now, I'm using these dual boards from V Flats. They have some amazing textures. In this texture specifically, I'm using like this concrete gray. I feel like it played well with the wood and the greens and the orange of like the butternut squash. One of the challenges that I had in this particular photo was that I'm dealing with multiple items, right? I'm dealing with multiple pieces of props, multiple pieces of food, like the bread, the baguette, is it baguette, baguette? That the bread, the French bread, I have a loaf that I placed on the right side. I did a couple slices and put it on the wood board that surrounded the bowls. So it was cool to be able to just be able to play around with it and just like have fun and not really stress out about it. And just trying to make sure like, you know, what I'm doing complements the story, which is the main characters are like, is the soup. Now, when it comes to adding props and your dishes in the placement itself, you want to think about what happens after the photo. Right? Are you gonna be using it for social media? Not just for Instagram, not just for Pinterest. Are you using it as an advertisement piece? Are you using it as a Facebook post or an ad? Are you gonna be adding text to it? So you wanna think about placement. It doesn't always have to be dead centered. It could be maybe veered to the right, maybe veered to the left, maybe the bowl could be on the right and maybe some other objects above it. And maybe you have that nice area of text towards the corner. Also think about maybe taking multiple variations of the actual dish itself. So, you know, you could have a dead center photo. You know, maybe you could have that photo with less props and maybe it's just the bowl with the bread. Totally take advantage of the props that you have, create multiple types of photos that tell the same story, and it just feels all cohesive, very nice. Now, if you're planning on trying to get into food photography, I would suggest try simple items to take photos of and practice with. Don't worry about having to create this lavish dish, like, you know, cooking it, like ribs and just making it look all beautiful, because, you know, all that stuff takes time, and then you might overwhelm yourself when you actually take the photo and you notice that things are getting cold, it's not looking right. But I hope you get my point. Something that's gonna be super easy for you to shoot that you can take your time with without having to worry about, oh, it's gonna mess up or it's gonna look not as great, especially if you're taking longer than you usually should. So yeah, those are the few tips that I wanted to give you guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Until next time, stay awesome, stay fresh, keep creating. Peace.